Yo, what it do? Today is Thursday, February 17th, 2022. I'm about to go to the gym, but it's actually my brother's birthday because my little brothers, they're twins, and it's their birthday today. So, you know, special episode, I guess you could call it. I don't know. But I'm still editing the vlog right now. I haven't posted it yet, right? But I'm thinking I'm going to add in my workouts for today, and then I'm gonna edit it, and then I will release the vlog finally. So I'm gonna be calling the vlog Tuesday to Tuesday. That doesn't mean that it gets released every Tuesday, but I will eventually try to get on a schedule where I'm releasing an episode every Tuesday or something like that, once a week or as many times a week that I can. But you know, just figured I'd record something today before I go to the gym, let y'all know it's my brother's birthdays, and going to the gym. I'm going a little bit late. It is like 9:06 right now. I'm using my phone to record, so I can't check the time, but it's like 9:06. Typically, I like to go to the gym at like 5 in the morning when it opens, like 5:30. That's when my gym, my local gym opens. That's the time I like to get in and then be out. But then now I have been consistently training certain clients, and they like to come in at like, you know, 10:30, 11. So it's easier for me to go in later, get my workout in. As soon as I finish my workout, they're getting in and I'm training them. So I'll also link in a session that I did with them last week in the vlog. I'll also put that. So yeah, that's that. If you want any workout plans, meal plans, you want some t-shirts, you want some gear, let me know, because I am a producer of all that. So we can do the workout plans, we can do the meal plans. If you want to buy some merch off of me, you can do all that. You get what I'm saying? Independent, self-made, or self producing, whatever the case you want to call it, man. But peace. This is your boy. I'm coming in with a voice recording just so I can explain what you see right here in the clip. So this is my last warm-up exercise of abs. I typically pyramid all my sets. The first set is 15 reps. I increase the weight. On my second set, I do 10 reps. I increase the weight. I do 5 reps on my third set. I repeat the third set for the fourth set. Then I lower the weight and I go back to 10 reps for the fifth set. And then I go back to the original weight I started at, and then I do 15 reps. This, because it is a ab, this machine or this contraption, it doesn't really allow for me to continuously add on weight. I do have a 35-pound plate in there. Don't know if you can really see it or not, but that's pretty much what I'm doing. This is my last set of 15 reps. So what I like to do is I do the back, I do each side, which targets the obliques, then I finalize with the front. So I'm just working my abs all the way through. And the reason why you do the back is because your back is connected to your abs. You get what I'm saying? So as odd as it may look to people, I know what I'm doing. Thank you for your time. I will be back with another voiceover in the episode. All right, y'all. You know, if you watched the first vlog episode that I talked about, Illuminati Confessions, I want you to check this out. I'm watching Westworld, right? Season 3, Episode 1. I've already watched Westworld. I love it because it's deep. It's got a lot of occult, esoteric messages and so forth, right? Think about how long it takes to film a season, right? Do a quick Google search on when the third season was released. You'll find this on Google. It was released on March 15th, 2020. That is also the day that in America, we officially went on lockdown, right? Check this out.
Come with me. Tomorrow, I have to head back to the States.
I can't. I have meetings here.
Take a day off.
Hold on. We're just going to get to it.
Interview over.
All right. I have my subtitles on because I was trying to read something that they said about the brain on here.
Interview over.
Why the fuck is this dude wearing a mask, bro? This episode, season 3, episode 1. Westworld season 3 was released on March 15th, 2020. Before the pandemic, before the whole psychological, you know, warfare, tyranny, oppression of wearing a mask. Why does this guy have a mask on in a future reality? Because this timeline of Westworld, this is supposed to be the future. Like, it's not, this isn't happening in 2020 or 2022. I think in Westworld, they're probably in like the 2040s or something like that, or maybe 2030s, but they are ahead of us technically. Why does this dude have a mask on? This is proof of predictive programming. Bruh, like in Asia, it's been kind of like a fashion statement, right? To wear a mask. And that became, as far as I remember, you know, it became a fashion statement or a thing that people did after SARS. SARS first hit in 2001. White people, Europeans, Americans weren't wearing masks casually. But dude is wearing a mask in this show that was released March 15th, 2020. You're telling me this is a coincidence or predictive programming? I'm going to go with predictive programming / Illuminati confession. And then when you think about the caliber of Jonathan Nolan's writing, Christopher Nolan's writing, you know, because Jonathan Nolan is the director and writer of Westworld, one of the writers on Westworld, and Jonathan Nolan is Christopher Nolan's brother. Those dudes, they make crazy movies, like, smart as fuck. You get what I'm saying? Like, but I'm just saying, they're tapped in to Hollywood, like, you know, like, they're kind of like, I wouldn't compare them to the Wachowskis, because some people would go as far as to say that the Wachowskis are hacks, but think about it, bro. This is predictive programming right here. This is proof of it. Just wanted to let y'all know. Peace.
Chicken,
some yo, that's so meta, because right now I'm reviewing episode 1, but this recording is probably gonna be for episode 2. So today is Saturday, September 19th. Ooh, September. I don't know why I always say Saturday, September. Something's up. Something's gonna go down in September, I guess. But today is Saturday, February 19th, 2022. It's actually my boy's birthday. Shout out Flex Champ. I'm gonna give you a call in a little bit. But yeah, man. So last week I did shrooms on Saturday and Sunday. The week before that I did shrooms on Sunday. This week I'm doing shrooms on a Saturday, baby. It's not that much, but you know, 3 weeks straight of doing shrooms. I feel incredible. This is why you're now starting to see regular vlogs from me. I bet. I don't know. I haven't even released this one yet, but I'm confident that I will. The whole point for me is to just get people on this level of understanding that, you know, like I said in episode 1, spirituality, esotericism, occult, whatever you want to call it, new age philosophy, it's 24/7. This belief in God, this love and trust and faith in the universe, this search for knowledge, it's 24/7. So, I mean, all day, you know, like, I got the Bhagavad Gita, you get what I'm saying? We're not biased. I got the Holy Bible app on my phone. You get what I'm saying? I still got to get me the Torah. But, you know, Secret Teachings of All Ages, that's another favorite book. I'm watching Westworld. I'm rewatching it. You get what I'm saying? So I'm all about, you know, mentality and everything like that. So peep this pyramid, workout pyramid, Maslow's pyramid of needs, or hierarchy of needs, pyramids in Egypt, right? Vitruvian Man. See, the philosophy of the Vitruvian Man. Matter of fact, that's what this episode is going to be about. Vitruvian Man, Tummo breathing right here in the corner. That was a picture, that was a cutout of some lungs that explained a lot about breathing. Maslow's hierarchy of needs, once again. You get what I'm saying? I actually misspoke. This isn't the hierarchy of needs. This is the pyramid of sciences. So you first start off with mathematics, then you go into physics, chemistry, biology, psychology, social sciences, and then arts. The arts are the highest form of science. And so, you know, because bodybuilding is an art, aesthetics is an art, it's a scientific process that you have to learn before you can really get your physique looking good. So that's why, for me, there is no personal training without talking about eating, without talking about spirituality, because your belief in God or your belief in life or your belief in the universe and its power will fuel your mentality when you go to the gym. Why are you lifting weights? What is the purpose? Are you doing it just to get girls? That's pretty shallow. And I'm saying this for the men, right? But like, you know, for the ladies, I don't know what shallow reasons. Maybe you're trying to get yourself a sugar daddy or a rich man, whatever shallow kind of, you get what I'm saying?
Yo, so I just wanted to make a quick interjection. In that last clip or in this clip, right? Even though I am saying, you know, men, are you going to the gym to get girls? And girls, are you going there to get, you know, sugar daddies or a man? This also applies to gay, bisexual, lesbian, sexually fluid, pansexual, whatever. I'm just talking about just in general. Are you in the gym for shallow reasons, or are you in there understanding with the comprehension, seeking to comprehend your own body? I just want y'all to know that I am not anything like that. It's just, you know, I'm heterosexual, so my orientation or like my mental way of thinking is going to, you know, like that's how I'm going to talk. I'm mainly going to refer to guys who like girls. But at the same time, if you're a guy who likes guys and you're in the gym just because you want to get a new guy, that's also shallow. The women, same thing. If you're a girl that's in there that also likes girls, and you're just, you get what I'm saying? Like, I'm not, yeah, I don't know. I know that this culture is super PC and all this other stuff, but, you know, like, yeah, I had to add that distinction just so, like, the message does not get lost in translation. All right, man, peace.
What are you in the gym for? Are you there for mental clarity? Are you there because you understand that breathing is the rhythm that connects you to life, and the better you are at working out, the stronger your cardiovascular abilities are, the better you're going to breathe through life, through life's most stressful situations, etc., etc. You get what I'm saying? So it's just this really large philosophy, this really big philosophy that people really kind of just, you know, oh no, I'm just trying to, you know, I'm just gonna be on this workout plan 3 months, and then once I get ripped, that's it. It's like, no, bro, there is no destination. The journey is the destination. Understanding the journey is the destination. Once you fully comprehend why you're on this journey, then you have arrived. You get what I'm saying? And we're constantly going through that. I was always on this journey of, damn, bro, like, I'm just trying to make money so that I can create the content that I want to create so that I can help wake people up. And then it was only till recently, right, that it finally clicked. Like, bro, it doesn't matter if you got money right now or not. Do the best that you can to create the content to wake the people up, and the money that you need will come. The universe will always provide. So, you know, I do advertise in my videos to say, if you want personal training, if you want one of my shirts, the merchandise that I make, if you want any of that, hit me up and you can buy it. But even if you don't, somehow the money is magically going to appear. That's just how God works. That's how the universe works. Research manna from heaven. when Moses and the Israelites were trapped in the desert, research manna from heaven. You get what I'm saying? God will provide no matter what. You just have to, kind of like what they say in Angels in the Outfield, right? Or was that Noah and the Bible? Either way, build it and they'll come. You get what I'm saying? Build it and they'll come. So that's going to be the, I think that's going to be the title of this second episode. Build it and they'll come, and Vitruvian Man. Or burgers for the boys. Because I was going to let y'all know, last week I was eating burgers like crazy. And I love my own homemade burgers because I know how to keep them healthy and et cetera, et cetera. So it's like, I love talking about cooking. I love cooking. You get what I'm saying? And the whole purpose of being better at cooking is so that your nutrition is on point, so that your gym gains are on point. And it's just this revolving, you get what I'm saying? It's a circle, it's a cycle, it's an ecosystem. And that's why people need to realize that although a pyramid is a very powerful structure, for us to move in the most cognizant way, like, you know, you have to understand it's a circle. There's a balance. There is no higher or lower. It's just this, you feel me? So yeah, man, stay tuned. I got more episodes coming. Peace. Yo, what it do? So it's still Saturday, the 19th of February. I just got back home from buying some groceries, and on my way there, cause y'all know earlier I drank some shrooms or some shroom tea, but on the way there, I really felt like, damn, these mushrooms are hitting. So I'm about to go run, you feel me, like 10 miles. There's this place that I run to, and I've long been trying to put it on video just to show, like, I can do this sober, but you feel me, right now, the way that the shrooms are hitting, I'm like, man, I gotta go on a run. The reason why I'm going on a run is so that I focus on my breathing. The better I get at breathing, the more comfortable I can feel in my body. During high periods of stress, I can maintain an even, calm breathing pattern because I'm doing rigorous exercise. Is it rigorous or vigorous? Rigorous. I don't know. I'm Scooby-Doo for the moment then. Anyway, Raggy, rigorous. You know, you're doing extensive work out there, you get what I'm saying? So exercising, putting a lot of stress and tension on your body. But as you learn how to breathe through that, all the mind knows is, oh, when it gets stressful, maintain breathing or control the breathing. So when mental stress hits you, which is the brain registers mental stress and physical stress the same. It's stress. You get what I'm saying? So yeah, whenever physical stress ends, mental stress ends up hitting you, because of this physical training that you do, you're better equipped to handle yourself in this very stressful world and life. So I will record part of the run, I think, but if not, deuces, I'ma just take pictures of something, you know, my locations or something. I'm just trying to go. I'm high as fuck. Peace. Thank you.
Hey, horse!
He can't hear me. That's my dog, though. I'll be saying what's up to that horse all the time. But he looks depressed. Oh, you see he's turning his head?
Hey, horse! What's good, bruh?
You see his ear turn? That's my nigga, bruh.
All right, bro, I'll see you next time. I love you, brown stallion.
See, I knew he was a stallion. This is why my nigga is sad. Look at them, bruh. They got these two in there together. They might be some fillies, you know what I mean? Young fillies. And my boy horse is a fucking stallion. So he just, you know, he just gets to impregnate them and that's about it. But for the most part, he's to the neck, bro. I think those might be some fillies. They might be colts. I don't know, I can't tell from here. But I see another single horse in that stable too. Oh no, we gonna keep running, folks. We gonna keep running. But I'm on my way back home, so now I'm not taking the run as serious. But I just wanted to show y'all that this is what I do. I does this, man. I do this run at least once a week, you know? At the longest, once every 2 weeks. But for the most part, once a week. So yeah, man, just keep it going. Peace.